Hello YouTube, this is Keith Kevin Ken. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. It's Friday. Oh man. Thank goodness it's Friday. It's just been one of those weeks. In and out of meetings every single day this week. Even a full day meeting, which I think I still haven't recovered from. Just meetings after meeting, even on Friday. I have one this afternoon. So that's me. That's real life. This is about real life, but also fun. Talking about what's going to fill our pockets. Friday, February 3rd, 2017. Oh, thank goodness it's Friday. Finally. Ah. I do feel good about that. Let's talk about the pocket dump deconstruction. What you see in front of you is what's going to fill my pockets. Yes, 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 I'm in a carbon fiber mood. Didn't start out that way. I do have a knife that got away, but I am in a carbon fiber mood. It just makes me feel good. It does. I took a bunch of photos. I'm going to post them on Instagram around noonish, one-ish, two-ish, who knows when. Oh, man. you know, though, I have fun talking to you guys, so it always starts my morning off right. Turned my iPhone 6S Plus after taking the photos from photo to video, and now it's time to talk about the pocket dump deconstruction. The watch, this is like the third Rolex I wore this week. And part of it has been, and I've only gotten three. Four. One of them is I don't use in my regular rotation. This, though, is the classic Rolex Datejust. Again, when you see three Rolexes in a week, you know I've been in meetings, right? Trying to dress it up a bit. I like the Rolex Datejust. I know. It's not for everyone. I actually, and I said this before to someone, and someone said, are you crazy? I like it. It is not a chronograph. I can't afford a Rolex chronograph. But I actually think it works dressed up and cash as well, especially business cash because it's Friday. You got to love it. It's business cash what you're wearing, but man, the attitudes are, at least for me, sometimes where I work, like in meeting times, the attitude's not casual. Anyway, knock wood, I've got a job, I've got a living. That is the Rolex Datejust, which I just love. Oh, sniffing a cigar through the day, I'll tell you. I hope there isn't a study about sniffing cigars that's bad for you, but it just reminds me of what's waiting. Sometimes that's enough. This is just a wonderful Romeo and Julieta short Churchill. I love those. Cuban cigar. I love getting a box of these and knowing that they're there in the humidor. Ah. Sometimes when I'm real sleepy, like today, not getting enough sleep because of work and then after work. You guys ever get in that cycle? After work, when it's like and it's not tough, it's just work, but it's meetings. For me, meetings wear me out. I don't know. That's one reason I went into consulting, and I could do so much work because I wasn't bogged down with meetings. But they just wear me out. And then at the end of the day, I'm like, man, I've been in meetings all day, so stop at a neighborhood pub and then stumble in, smoke the cigar with nothing, you know, and then all of a sudden, I'm waking up in the middle of the night, hoarse like I am now. So, good booze, you don't have the headache, but boy, everything else you feel. Let's talk about, so that's the cigar. Of course, my Schon Design pen. It's to me almost like the Rolex or a Sabenza or something. It's like classy, tough. Cash and classy. This is the full tie version, which I really like. Shown design pen. You guys know because I do it on all my pocket dump deconstructions except on the weekends. Just my pen of choice now. Thin Coach wallet, one of the thin Coach wallets that I use. The coin for today, you guys getting tired of me bringing up the coin. It's just for a year, I didn't know how to show you guys coins. Now I'm like, how about bringing it up to the camera, Kevin? Duh. This right here is the very first Australian koala coin. It was from 2007. Just a nice one. Now, of course, they do them every single year. But again, the very first silver 1 ounce koala coin. You know, they put them in every other size as well. Again, I was collecting all of the koalas. I collect every series, and when I sold them all for the profit, when it hit $50 an ounce, I did keep the good stuff. And I just wanted to keep the first one. Of course, I always carry a silver 1 ounce coin. It's just a thing I do. It's for good luck. And again, I tell people it's because of my grandfather always had a silver dollar or two or three or four in his pockets. You know, silver dollars, man. You know, the old silver dollars before 1964, dated before 1964, you put a bunch of those in your pocket and they bounce together. It's not like coins bouncing together now. It's got that thud. But when you pull out one of those big coins, put it on a counter and say, "Hey, you guys, go get handfuls of candy." Well, penny candy. Ah, oh, man. Get those little brown paper bags, real small brown paper bags that later on when I went to college, people put glue in. That's a whole other story. But you just fill it with all, go around the counter and fill it with dollar candy. I mean, dollar candy. I'm sorry. That's today. Now you fill it with penny candy. It was just wonderful, man. Ah, Twizzler sticks and long thick pretzels and all that stuff is just great. Anyway, Mary Jane's. Okay, enough of that. You know, the great thing, I'm just throw this out. I love Amazon. I love you too. I think those are my two best, to me, best websites. It's just wonderful. But you know, you guys, and I know a lot of you are younger, so let's say what? The 2000s and the 90s. And 80, I do have a wider range of people as well, some my age. But Amazon, man, you just Google the kind of candy, 80s candy, and they have packages of the old candy, which means there are companies still doing Mary Janes and Big Pretzels and all of that stuff. Try doing that sometimes to see what pull up. Again, my dream. This is about dreams in your pocket daily that keeps you going. It's also about where you're going. The overall arching thing, if you were talking to Kevin years ago, it would be strive. And there are still people on YouTube that do that. And you know what? I'm a subscriber. I like to see how the younger people are doing their motivational stuff for work. But my message in my last years, because it's a message to myself, it's life. Work helps you do life. And I wasted many years on that kind of stuff. But that's what I want to do too. I talk about when I get my van or whatever. Maybe I'll just start it in my car. The next phase of these vlogs and stuff, going around the great US of A and going to cigar shops and knife shops and going to manufacturing places, watch shops. Maybe one day, if I ever get away, Shown Design Pens. Again, I don't know them. I know their product and I love their product. But also, I'd love to go and see the old candy factories. Wouldn't that be nice? See if they have tours doing that kind of thing. Anyway, enough of me. Me. I have to remember that there's something coming. When you have a week of meetings and it's work, besides a paycheck, you got to think, you know, when I don't work, what am I going to be doing? I'm always going to work, but when I go into that pleasurable work. Let's see. I've decided I needed some classics. I've got the Rolex classic Datejust, and I wanted a classic, a really classic Spyderco Cricket. You guys know my love for the Spyderco Cricket. I have a extensive Spyderco Cricket collection, which starts with the very first one ever made. One of the first ones made. This is an older cricket. That's the hint. It's not, the more modern ones have the frame lock. This one does not. It has a liner lock. That's when you know it's the older version. It's a little thicker. I like it. It feels good. It feels better in your hand because it's thicker. This is one of the carbon fiber ones. That's rare. It's hard to find. Carbon fiber under plexiglass or something. I call it plexiglass. I don't know what it is. That's Kevin saying it's smooth. You're not really feeling the carbon fiber, but very nice. I love the older versions because you don't have the frame lock. You have this nice smooth on the back as well. This right here, especially as an old one, I have a keychain. It's only a silver loop with two keys. If I didn't always use things for keychains, and especially when I have a important knife on it, and I do, I carry it because I take my keys out and put it on my desk a lot in my office. It just looks nice. And I say it all the time now because it was such a simple idea that I never took advantage of. I love these things. Again, it's so wonderful to put your bill, especially the ones without the backlog. If you can find a nice one, I was so lucky to get this in perfect condition. And then with the clip, just put your bills, your license, your a credit card or something, and you've got just a wonderful money clip. Just wonderful money clip, right? Man, this is perfect as that and useful. This, of course, has a spidey edge. All of the crickets have that reverse X, reverse X, reverse S blade. You can also tell it's the older one. It's a 1.9-inch blade. The blade steel is the early steel, one of Spyderco's early favorites, ATS-55, ATS-55 blade steel, but just a wonderful knife. Classic. It does give me a little bit of shivers, and I know it's about things when I'm talking to you guys, but I feel the same way about people. I've never been starstruck, and so I tend to get aggressive with people. I was just brought up that way. Everybody's human beings, whatever. But I do recognize when I meet someone that I admire, and a lot of times I don't even know I admire them until I start talking to them. And it could be anything very, very small, Hey, I've been married for 35 years. I admire that. I was married for 14, and I thought that was an achievement. I knew it was the ultimate is to still be together, but what it takes to still be together. And I've seen people who are very wealthy, that own a piece of the Transamerica building in San Francisco, and so, but you can be in awe in a lot of things. I'm in awe of a lot of people on YouTube, young folks just stepping out there. They don't have the best videos, they don't have a lot of views, they don't have anything, but man, I'm in awe of people who just step out there, man. So, hey, the medium knife, you guys know I love the small Inkosi. Oh man, we're getting close to tax time. And so you probably won't see a lot of new Inkosis coming for a couple of times, leading into tax, leading out of tax. If you've already filled out your tax returns, I know you're expecting money back. The early ones. Me, I'm gonna file right before midnight because I'm not expecting money back. But anyway, I really love this. This is a small Inkosi from Chris Reeve, 2.75 inch blade, S35VN steel. They are smaller than the small Chris Reeve Sabenza 21s. Those are around 2.9 inches. This is 2.75, and I like it. It's small. They have the profile of the Sabenza 25, plain and simple. There are some improvements that Chris Reeve did to this knife over the 25. They have huge washers, bronze washers. You can see on this smaller one a big pivot. They've done a number of things. They moved the clip off of the lock bar. I love them because I have a lot of Sabenza large, they only had large 25s. So I have a big collection of Sabenza 25s. In fact, on this channel, go to the Chris Reeve playlist and you can see that collection. And so for me, large Inkosis are 25s with some improvements, but I'm okay with that. When they did the small Inkosi, first, I favor a smaller knife, but the other reason, really, is that I have no small Sabenza 25s because there were no such thing. So this was a whole different category for me, and I really like it. Of course, this is from the good folks at KnifeArt.com, and it's the carbon fiber Sabenzas. They have all of the Sabenzas except for the that's why it's Sabenzas. I said Sabenzas. They don't have Umnumzuns in carbon fiber. Wouldn't that be interesting? A carbon fiber Umnumzun. It's exclusive to KnifeArt.com. I have the entire collection, you know, the large and small Sabenza 21, the Sabenza 25, and now the small Inkosi. I don't know. Can you see that? Number three there. That number three, when they released it, they sent it to people on their mailing list. I was at work. I remember when they did. They said, hey, we have the exclusive carbon fiber. By that time, I was on their website ordering it. And I got number three. I didn't even know they had them numbered. I love it because even on the birth certificate, it has number three, the third one. And so I'm really proud of that. If you get any of the carbon fibers, they come with a special bead on the lanyard, but they're very light. My favorite Sabenzas, you know, just very light because of that thick carbon fiber instead of the titanium. Of course, you have the back lock as usual. I don't know why this keeps going out of focus, but back lock, which is usual and all of the other things. That is the small Inkosi. It's exclusive from KnifeArt.com. They still have them, the large and the small, in carbon fiber. They no longer have the numbered ones, but they still have them. And man, this is like, for me, the perfect knife. I just really like it. I do. And then, yes, it's not a big cutting day today because I've got some real bangers as far as just classy carry, just a classy carry. You know, a lot of times for me, especially when I'm in meetings and stuff and doing work, and by the way, I said, oh, I want to do pleasure work. This is my dream job. It's just, as I think I even said here, you know, I knew a guy who shot photographs for Playboy for years. When I was consulting, I sat next to him on a plane and I went, oh my goodness, you know, I saw the camera back. I'm like, man, I have this thing about photography, but I have never put in the time I really want to. And he says, oh, I gotta go back to work. I'm like, what do you do? Sound like me, right? Oh, I shoot nudes for Playboy. He's showing me his picture. I'm going, okay. That just proves to me that no matter what you do in life, you sit there shooting beautiful women in the nude all day and all night, flying first class and all that. Hey, I was a consultant at that time, okay? I don't do that now. I'm a big guy squeezed in. But all this stuff, and you're not like, can't wait for retirement. I'm like, are you kidding? That is my retirement gig. So it just goes to prove, hey, when you're forced to do something to pay the bills, no matter what it is work. I know I keep going off. This is just a piece of art. I just love this knife. And I wasn't forced, but people kept saying, you guys kept saying, come on, go with the CRU-WEAR. The Manix CRU-WEAR. And I'm so happy I did. This is a Knife Center exclusive. I think they're still available. I don't know if they're sold out, but you can find them still, even in the secondary market. Just a wonderful Manix. The Spyderco Manix is wonderful anyway. But this is carbon fiber, real carbon fiber. It feels so nice. I actually like with the Manix all the detailing that you can feel right there. It's just really nice. But it's light because of the carbon fiber. The blade is 3.4 inches. CRU-WEAR is the blade steel. It just lasts and lasts and lasts. Holds an edge. Just wonderful knife. Ah, it's beautiful. This is the large knife for me. It's a Knife Center exclusive 3.4 inch blade with that Spyderco leaf shape, the 50-50 chorl. It's CRU-WEAR, folks, and it's with carbon fiber. It just feels so great. That is my carry. That right there is my EDC. That's what I'm going to carry. That's going to help me get through my meetings. No, I'm not going to be stabbing people in the meetings. But I tell you, I will be hitting my pockets a lot to remind me of why I'm doing this when I hit the tough spot. I took pictures. It'll be on my Instagram at Keith Kevin King. Come join the fun. You guys need to be on Instagram anyway. Every knife person you know, cigar people, anything you like. If you like drawing, it's there. It's just really wonderful. Now Instagram has videos and stuff. I need to start taking advantage of that too. I keep saying what I need to do. And then Saturday and Sunday comes and I'm on the couch watching videos and just cooking Blue Apron. But that is my carry. I will be posting pictures. I usually post about 4 knife-related photos on Instagram daily. And I'm going to start doing some shorter, real short. You have to be on Instagram videos as well. But you know what? This isn't Instagram. This is the Keith Kevin Ken YouTube channel. And yeah, I woke up flipping this puppy. I did. It's the Microtech Ultratech. It's another variation. There's a million variations on it. I like this. You see that bayonet style? What do you think? Tactical? I think so. DLC coated. I love that they keep some of it not, which is great. L-Max steel. I don't know how close I can get this. This is the new handle. I said True Grip. And someone stopped me when I first said, it's the tri-grip because you have these triangles. You see the with the hardware as well, and it's really grippy. You know, usually when you get an Ultratech, it's aluminum and smooth and not as grippy. This is very grippy. It also flips out like a beast. A lot of, you know, I have 3 Microtech Ultratechs, and I love them dearly. They are a perfect size with a 3.4 inch blade, but to me it feels, you know, smaller. Out the front, double action, which means it flies out the front, obviously, and double action means it flies out and it pulls back. There are a lot of automatic out the fronts, a lot. There are some that are single action and then you do something else to bring the blade back in. It's just a really nice carry. This one just flips. You know, a lot of times you need 2 handers with some Microtechs, which is fine. You never need 2 hands to get that blade out fast. But I really like it. Really do. L-Max steel, as I told you, I do have a, Microtech Ultratech out the front, video. Go check it out. That's it. These are the knives, the knife that got away. I'm Kevin of Keith Kevin Ken. thank you all for your support. If you like these videos, thumb them up, share them. That's like them on YouTube, share them. The likes, just let me know you like them. It keeps me going, man. You just don't know how important those are to me. And it's not the numbers. It's just that I know that I should continue. Because doing every day, like the guy that was flying next to me, even doing every day shooting beautiful women nude, taking photographs of beautiful women nude, is hard sometimes. And so I love showing what's in my pocket every single day, 7 days a week, by the way. And we're going to continue to do that. And it's because of you guys. You guys just keep me going. I don't know what I'd do if I didn't have a chance to talk to you guys at least once a day. Wishing you the best, whether you're watching this on Friday, February 3rd, or you're watching it 2 weeks, a month, 2 years from now, I'm wishing you the best. Seriously. You just need to know at least one person is wishing you happiness and the best. You guys keep those pockets full. It'll make you feel good. It makes me feel good. Goodbye.